Welcome to a new lecture on medical termination of pregnancy in second trimester. So let us learn about the indications of medical termination of pregnancy. As I have said, when the diagnosis is delayed, the important indications of medical termination of pregnancy are, first, whenever there is some maternal illness, any maternal illness which can compromise the maternal health due to the pregnancy. So all those illnesses, for them you can do medical termination of pregnancy. If there are any types of fetal anomalies, maybe chromosomal, maybe congenital anomalies, in that cases we should do medical termination of pregnancy. When there is intrauterine death of the uterus, intrauterine death of the fetus in the uterus, even then you can use these methods to evacuate the fetus. So there are medical methods. There are intra-amniotic or extra-amniotic instillation of methods, and there are surgical methods. So first, let us learn about the medical methods which can be used in second trimester medical termination of pregnancy. The first medical method is using mifepristone and misoprostol. Okay, mifepristone is an anti-progestin. So this mifepristone, being an antiprogestin, it will soften the cervix and it will also cause decidual degeneration, thus causing abortion. Whereas misoprostol, it is PGE1 analog. So it is a prostaglandin E1 analog. As a result, this will activate uterine contractions and thus helps in abortion. So what is the dose that we give? It can be given in first, mifepristone, it is started 200 micrograms orally. First we start mifepristone, and then we will repeat it after 36 to 48 hours. Later we give misoprostol, and this misoprostol is given 800 micrograms vaginally first, and then 3 hours later we give the same misoprostol in 400 micrograms. It can be given either orally or vaginally, and this is repeated every 3 hourly for a maximum of 5 doses. Okay, so this will result in abortion. So we give first 200 micrograms orally mifepristone, then after 36 to 48 hours we give 800 micrograms vaginally misoprostol, and then 3 hourly, we give misoprostol 400 micrograms orally or vaginally, and this is repeated every 3 hourly for a maximum of 5 doses. Okay. Now, what are the complications of these medical methods? The main complication is, this can cause one incomplete abortion. Whenever it causes incomplete abortion leading to retaining of the products, then you will have to do dilatation and evacuation. Okay, if it causes infections, you will have to treat the infections with antibiotics. If it causes uterine rupture or any lacerations, uterine rupture or cervical lacerations, then you will have to do a surgical management. And if there is hemorrhage, then you will have to treat it. Okay, so these are the different complications which are available. So this is one method, which is mifepristone and misoprostol. The second drug which can be given is oxytocin. Even oxytocin can be given. This oxytocin is given in infusions. That is, you can start this oxytocin from 50 to 300 milliliters, units. You can give it in the range of 50 to 300 units in 500 ml of normal saline. But this oxytocin is progressively increased in concentrations. You won't give 300 units at a time. So you will slowly increase the concentration of oxytocin, but you are giving it in the doses of 50 to 300 units in 500 ml. Of normal saline. So these are the medical methods which are available for second trimester of trimester abortion. Now, the other methods, the second type of methods which are available, are the extra amniotic injection. of ethacridine lactate. Ethacridine lactate, extra amniotic injection of ethacridine lactate. So here, how are we going to do this? So this is the uterus. Okay, so this is the uterus. So this is the baby. So this is the baby, and this is the amniotic cavity. Okay, this is amniotic cavity. This is the baby, and this is the placenta. Okay, now what we do is, first and foremost, we will insert a Foley's catheter in the cervix. In the cervix, you are going to insert a Foley's catheter. So first, insert Foley's catheter. The Foley's catheter can be of 14 to 16 F size. It is introduced into the cervix. Okay, that is into the extra amniotic space. You are introducing it into the extra amniotic space. And then you have introduced into the extra amniotic space, and you have inflated the balloon. So inflate the bulb. So you have to inflate the bulb with 10 ml of saline. Okay, and this should occlude the cervix. Now you inject ethacridine lactate through the catheter. So with the help of the catheter, you are going to inject the ethacridine lactate, which is there, you are injecting it into the extra amniotic layer. So this extra amniotic instillation of ethacridine lactate, this will release the prostaglandins. So what does this ethacridine lactate do? This will release the prostaglandins. So these prostaglandins will cause uterine contractions. So this is how we are going to do extra amniotic injection of ethacridine lactate. Then the next type which is available is intra-amniotic infusion of substances. We can instill the substances intra-amniotically. That is called as intra-amniotic instillation of substances. Okay, what are we going to do? Through intra-amniotic instillation of substances. So this is the mother. This is the cervix. So this is the uterus. This is the sacrum. Okay, this is the sacrum, and this is the uterus. This is the vagina. Okay, and this is the baby. Okay, this is the placenta. Now we are instilling the substances into the uterine cavity. This intra-amniotic instillation of uterine of substances, it is done transabdominally. Transabdominally, we are inserting a needle and we are instilling the substances into it. So this is done one transabdominally. Transabdominally, with the help of a guidance, we will insert a needle into the uterine cavity. And then first you will aspirate a small amount of fluid. First you will aspirate a small amount of amniotic fluid. Okay, and then you will confirm that this the needle which we have inserted, it is in the amniotic cavity itself. And then there are two substances which can be used. We can instill either the hypertonic saline can be instilled, or you can even instill hyperosmolar urea into the amniotic fluid, amniotic cavity, because these are toxic agents. These will easily cause abortion. When we induce hypertonic saline, because the amount of osmolarity in the saline is more than the contents in the amniotic fluid, so all the contents, all the water leaks out, thus causing abortion. In hyperosmolar urea, this is urea, as a result it can cause abortion easily. Okay, so for hypertonic saline, the major contraindications are cardiac disease and renal diseases. The next method which are available are surgical methods. So in the surgical methods, you will have to see there is dilatation and evacuation of the cervix. Dilatation and evacuation can be done, or you can do hysterectomy. Okay, so these are the different methods which are done for second trimester abortion. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. If you have any doubts, please comment in the comment section. If you feel something is inadequate in this lecture, even then comment it in the comment section. Thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.